Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me. Spin and slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
Yeah, told him I would be a boss before I had business. I don't even need nobody here to vouch. I was all alone, so I ain't have a witness. Right back to the lab. Gotta go to work, I'm revving up my engine. I was just putting groceries in the bag. Now wait a minute, yeah, forgot to mention. I'm $100 million richer. Might paint $100 million picture. One man army, but I don't fatigue. Better have $100 million coming with you. Got good karma, so I'm riding fiscal. Hit the crossover, leave them playing Twister. Oh, they thought that I was just a... Now when I do, they call me mister. Stop it, did war with suffice. Play with the family, playing with your life. Just got the ops hurt, looking sick. So we gon' disinfect them like a wipe. Had that boy a big cat with no stripes. Now on the gram, ain't worried about a light. Yeah, I had to go ahead and raise the fee. If you ain't rockin' with it, take a hike.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin and slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Say you gon' ride. Is he gon' step by me? Can't do it back, keep racks on me. Nah, hell with, I keep three on me. Oh, so you ride it. I can do everything that you gon' like. Young, rich, and famous, I'm living the life. Oh, pull up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging up both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'm bringing it to you. They're a free agent, I give them the boo. I'm with the crew who we bringing it to. We got no limit yet, we on the ride. We all gon' step, we all gon' ride. Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me. Spin and slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
Every time I'ma step with the steppers, black and white bins looking like pepper.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the World Steel Capital in the city of Bridges, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Acrisure Stadium. Today, it's the opener of the 2023 NFL season, as it'll be the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. A new season of NFL football is here, and we're off in 2023 on EA Sports. Returning from his end zone is Ray-Ray McCloud. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. First play, and Purdy wants to throw it. And his first look is incomplete. Well, what a way to kick off the year here. Niners and Steelers. And I know the folks back in Northern California, happy to see their quarterback Brock Purdy back out there. Charles, what do you see from him in year two?
More of what we saw from him in year one, partner, because this young man, he really sees the reins in that first season. And he is excited about expanding his game and pushing the ball downfield even more in year two as a starter with the 49ers.
All right, so they got that one, Charles, against the center.
And let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion, and sometimes you got that big guy on your nose, you got sometimes where he's coming at you at an angle. It's a difficult job for him to snap the ball and then execute his block.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. McCaffrey running up the middle. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have to contend with a third and 13.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Throw there going to be incomplete.
That was the first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
So on fourth down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. Back deep, Patrick Peterson. Oh, it's a wobbler here. So that'll be marked down as a 19-yard punt. And the Steeler offense, they're set up nicely as they take over. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now the third-year man, Najee Harris. And now off to the races, down the right side. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Najee Harris, 36 yards. And the Steelers are on the board here first in the season opener. Well, you've got to like that start on both sides of the football. You force the three and out, and then you score on your first drive.
Well, I know someone who doesn't like that start.
Well, yeah, the other side.
Yeah, they don't like that at all, right? This is not the way it's supposed to be. But what you just described, that's team football, all right? When you get a three and out, you're supposed to take advantage of it on the offensive side of the ball. You said, thank you very much for giving us the ball. Let's put it in the end zone, and they did exactly that.
Well, now to kick it away after the touchdown. Here's McLeod from his end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Never leave the house without the pack. Where my at? Take an L and try to double back. We ain't doing that. Say she mad, but I know it's cap. I've been through with that. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. I ain't got a, but they hands to the ceiling. Myself a promise young. I would never work a day job, put it in the safe. Never know when I'm gonna need that. Came here with my gang, you don't know where your homies at. Gave you a lot of game, you don't owe me back. You say you a boss, gotta show me that. Never leave the house without the pack. Where my at? Take an L and try to double back. We ain't doing that. Say she mad, but I know it's cap. I've been through with that. Someone to hype me up, hype me up, hype me up, need someone to hype me up, hype me up, hype me up, need someone to hype me up, hype me up, hype me up, need someone to hype me up, hype me up, hype me up, hype me up. I got game for a center, 20 bands for the dinner, 20 dips in a sprinter.
been smooth for so long, I'm trying to get rough. Buffing my nails, dog, I'm trying to get buff. Shaping my beard up, I'm liking the scruff. The hills, cause I'm living my life in the cut. Can't imagine that I'm gonna meet my wife in the club. We gon' see though, I feel like she more of a CEO. Or maybe she doing volunteer work in Rio. It's not like I need her, but I would love to meet her. Another day, another dollar, another phone with another feature. I don't play goalie, but I'm my brother's keeper. Surrounded by family, I'm not with other people. They say I got my pop's demeanor and mother's features. The garden's still private as ever. The gang thriving together. Your boy's striving to be the most dominant ever. The hardest white boy since the one who rapped about vomiting sweaters and holding comments. Cause I promise you I'm honestly better than whoever came to your head right then. They ain't cut from the same thread like him. They don't study doing work to get ahead like him. They don't toss and turn in a bed like him. Cause they don't love it. 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 I've been laid back so long, I'm trying to get turned. Searching my name, dog, that's how you get hurt. Being likable, I'm trying to be unbreakable. I just realized that this whole game is takeable if I want it. And I do, yes, I want it. I don't care how you feel about it. I do what I want. I used to look up to the people that I'm moving in front of. It's not that crazy anymore. My city used to a come up. Bryce and Jack G. James is up next. The rest is up to me. These lames is upset. My peers get upstaged. The fans are obsessed. My city is upcoming. These people are oppressed. And I'm going to change things. I'm up at Carmichael's trying to get on the same page. I heard about the rapper that you claim was a mainstay. They had a nice run, but they never gonna maintain because they don't love it. 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 They don't love it.
Hold up. Listen. The past bananas, but I haven't seen it. You thought it was over. You brag of ignorance. You lack the vision. I'm sacrilegious. I feel my wrath as you ever been in my clearly crafted mission with crass intentions. You may have given the credit so quick you save now. No. This ain't the end and you might as well go and lay down. No. Make way to witness the heights are going, I'm paid down. Whoa. You pray for distance from guys like me, it's too late now. Preparation means opportunity, no. Being great as ambiguity, no. Too much at stake for your foolery, is it though? Keep on hating, it's fuel to me, did you know?
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Acrisure Stadium on the north shore of the Steel City, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Today, it's the opener of the 2023 NFL season, as it'll be the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. Two teams with 11 Super Bowl titles between them, the Niners and Steelers underway to begin 2023. Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. Here's the Pro Bowler, Christian McCaffrey, and he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Play action, and now here's Purdy to throw it. Oh, his first throw of the season is intercepted. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick, and he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Well, they certainly took a shot to open this game. I know it backfired with the interception, but no lack of bravado from that sideline at all. And look, they told us before the ball game, they wanted to be a little more dangerous on offense. They wanted to take a few more chances. That opening pass certainly set a tone. Maybe a turnover, but I don't think it'll stop them from trying again the rest of this game.
Now a first down carry for Harris. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 45-yard line. A Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. They run the play fake. Here's Pickett. Now a short pass pulled in by Washington. Just a gain of a couple there. And it'll be second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
And trying to push forward, but he is going to be stuffed up in the backfield. Now they're staring at a third and eight. That last play, backwards a yard. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Off the play fake, here's Pickett. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. Okay, so roughing the passer, and I've got to imagine that's the last thing you want to see week one is your quarterback taking an unnecessary hit.
I think you're exactly right about that. You hate it any week, but boy, are you on target. This is a unit that's depending on him to take him through 17 games, so you definitely can't let him get hurt right now.
First and 10, here's Pickett. Finding Johnson on the out route. That's complete. So give him 2 yards there on the completion, and it'll be second down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
And they'll send the tight end in motion left. Second down, here's Pickett. And this is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Pickett. Incomplete.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
So Pickett is off to the sideline and Chris Boswell is on for the Steeler field goal try. A 33-yarder from the left hash. Boswell's kick is good, and the Steelers will jump out to a 3-0 lead. That's a pretty good opening drive. That'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted six, but they got three in the early lead.
And they should be happy. That was a good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope that good things are in store here today for them.
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away. Here's McLeod from his end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And one of the things we like to hit on every year are the new rule changes. So we got a few for 2023. A lot are procedural, having to do with deadlines and roster construction and such. But two kind of caught my eye, Charles. One is the option to fair catch a kickoff and have it come out to the 25 like it does in college. You like that?
I don't. I don't like it at all. I don't like it in college. I don't like it in the NFL. I want to have something different. And I really wanted the special teams coach to be a little bit more involved. I do understand why the league is doing it. They believe it promotes safety, and it's hard to argue against that.
What about the versus the other one, guys can now wear the number zero. We've already seen some make the switch. Calvin Ridley, DeAndre Swift, Braxton Berrios, amongst others.
Yeah, and you know something? When you see those guys make that move, I don't mind that at all right? A little more expressionism for these guys, I love it. I just think we didn't go far enough. What about double zero, like Jim Amo used to wear, or Kenny Burrell used to wear? Let's add that back to the NFL jerseys.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first two drives. It looks like they have to give up the football again after this one.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away. On the return is Peterson. It's a 42-yard punt, but eight on the return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They finished off their opening drive of the campaign with a field goal on the last drive. Now they'll search for a touchdown here on this go-around. First and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Well, these Steelers, Charles, 9-8 a year ago. Their quarterback, Kenny Pickett, made 12 starts as a rookie. Do you see a jump coming both for him and potentially for this franchise?
I do, and I trace it back to a December game against Baltimore in 2022. Kenny Pickett made some big plays down the stretch to give Pittsburgh a victory. Plus, the Steelers have added some nice pieces around him, and they'll be able to protect him even better in 2023.
Throwing on third down, here's Pickett. And that's caught inside the 30. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Here's second and 10. Harris running straight ahead. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Nothing after one on EA Sports. Second quarter action from Pittsburgh. It is the Steelers in control of the football as they've got it with a third down coming up. Here's Pickett. That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least, it'll be fourth down.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it, and oftentimes, not get away.
So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Now, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Purdy slow, complete here to Ayuk. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down. And they'll try to run the option here. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. Pretty good job there defensively of stringing that one out.
Yeah, you've got a quarterback who's waiting and waiting for something to develop, and it just never materialized, and down he went behind the line of scrimmage.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down try that's knocked away and incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defensive player with some confidence, haven't allowed a point yet, flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw, Purdy.
Time to gather on the sidelines and try to figure out what's going wrong. Who has an idea? Who has a plan? Time to implement it.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Now it's Peterson. It's a 43-yard punt, a return of 5. And they will take over first and 10. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And their two drives thus far both led to points, albeit both field goals, so the lead just 6-0, but the ability to move the ball is evident.
Well, that's, you know, heartening, as they say, but it's not what they're about. What they're about is putting the ball in the end zone and putting sixes on the board. So if you're the offensive coordinator, you like what you're doing, but you don't love it. You've got to find a way to ring that bell. Then you can have a little self-satisfied grin. Right now, a little more determination is needed.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Warren will try the right side. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. It's a loss of 4. Now third down.
How about the job there on the outside? Shed the wide receiver and was able to make the tackle on the perimeter.
And the Steelers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be third and forever. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Here's one deep for Pickens. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Two things you can do in that situation. Run and punt the football or try and take your shot at getting the first down. They chose the latter, but they'll have to punt all the same.
Now on fourth down, Presley Harvin on to punt for the Steelers. Right on the chalk of the 20-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. Let's see if they can do better here on this drive. The tackle by Cole Holcomb.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
They run the option here on first and 10. And he is not going to go anywhere. We're going to get to him behind the line, and that is going to get us to the two-minute warning. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Purdy now to throw off the play action. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And able to get this one across the 40. He's brought down. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts.
So as they talk it over, we step aside.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll bring a tight end in motion left. They go play action here, Purdy. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again, or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
Second and 10. In motion left here, one of their tight ends. On second down, McCaffrey. And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Here's Purdy now on third and goal. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
This defense not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Here's Mitch Wishnowsky now on to punt. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This
throw left side is complete on the diving effort. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. To the air on first down with Pickett. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Talanoa Hufanga. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Devontae Kaysen. And the Steelers are going to have it here just past the 25. Well, their defense got him the football with an interception. They trot out there, Charles, in the first play. They give the football right back.
Brandon, I almost expect you coming like an auctioneer. We've got two, we got two. Do I hear three? Remember,
Rush coming in, he's taken down. Slipping into the backfield for the sack was Oren Burks.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
Now Pickett. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sacked on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw, Pickett. This is caught by Robinson. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. On fourth down, here's Presley Harvin on to punt. Take it right on the 30. 39-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Final play of the half, Purdy. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And the half will begin with a touchback. Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
They hand this off to Harris. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. From the 44-yard line, here's second down and three. Now Pickett will look to pass it. Here's one deep for Pickens. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. They were ahead of schedule after the gain of 7 on first down, but the defense does not budge on second and third. The Steelers send out their punter now as he'll come on to kick this one away. And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Niners set up well. They take over first and 10 on the short side of the field. Looking to throw on first down here. But he will find his man, Samuel. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Well, that's the kind of play that was lacking all the way through the first half. Maybe this can give them a little bit of a spark because they're not out of this game by any stretch.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door.
But I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh, my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone, but now you've set yourself up for at least 2, maybe 3 more shots from close range.
McCaffrey is in. Touchdown, 49ers.
Well, we talk a lot about Christian McCaffrey and what he can do in the open field, and it's easy to gloss over how tough he can be to stop near the goal line. And he shows you just how tough he is on that carry as he takes it into the end zone.
Moody good with the extra point, and they take the lead here at 7-6. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Olszewski now from his end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Steelers take over a first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, struggles continue. Open targets, and he keeps missing them, pressing way too much. He may have a big arm, but until he learns how to harness it and have some touch, he's going to continue to struggle.
Try him with Pickett here on third down. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
Good clean play. No flags coming out of the pocket of the officials. Turns into an incompletion, and that should get them off the field with a 3 and out.
The Steelers send out their punter now. as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Yards on the punt there, and the Niners will go on offense, first and 10
at their own 39-yard line.
Get him,
put him down.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line.
But I think this will let it ride very simply because he overestimated his arm strength and his ability to fit it anywhere he wants to. A lot of quarterbacks do that and often pay the price.
On first and 10, it's Pickett. Complete, it's Johnson. He's got room to roam. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. D.T. Jackson, 34 yards. And the Steelers have retaken a third quarter lead. Good throw there, and I don't want to blow it too out of proportion, but he looks a lot more comfortable in his second season.
You can tell he put the work in the offseason, and what I mean by that is understanding the playbook, not just the plays and how to execute them, but how to do it against a variety of defenses, also understands his team better, what they can and cannot do. You can see the confidence rising in him as he plays.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're losing. They just haven't been able to get much of anything going in the pass game. And as you well know, in today's NFL, if the passing game isn't working, usually not much else is working either.
You're exactly right about that, partner. And I know that right now the easy answer would be, hey, let's run the football. But that might not be everything you need. So despite the fact that they've struggled throwing it, they've got to find some type of a play, multiple plays, that puts the ball in the air and allows for them to have some success.
And he'll get about three up past the 25. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. This offense on third down today, not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This is third and 9. Play action. Now Purdy winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by DeMonte Kazin. And he returns it into enemy territory down the 45-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. You can't simulate it, right? So your decision-making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 27 yards there, first down. Pickett will look to throw it here. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
And suddenly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
Now a second and 10. Now run straight ahead with Warren. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Pickett back to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six. Boswell's kick is good. And now that makes this a 15-7 game. From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do. We kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
Here's McLeod from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And remember, despite giving up the field goal, this is still a one-score game. They're in need of the touchdown and a two-point conversion. A field goal on this drive likely doesn't do them much good.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Second down and a little more than a yard here. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They held him in check in the first half, but that's his longest carry of the game right there.
So would this be the definition of fresh legs since he didn't get much done in the first half? Now he has a great opportunity. He's taking full advantage of it.
Here's Purdy on first and 10. And boy, another ill-advised throw there as that will wind up incomplete. Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Play action, and now here's Purdy to throw it. Able to find the open man. That's complete. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. An excellent gain, 35 yards.
Well, he reminded us that he was a 1,000-yard receiver a year ago as he starts off week one picking up right where he left off. He told us at the end of the preseason he was primed for a big year. He just gave us excellent evidence of his belief.
Cameron Hayward in on the tackle. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Another run with McCaffrey on second down. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 56 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
They'll try and power it in with Juszczyk. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Fourth quarter, down to the
final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And they're knocking on the door. Second and goal now in a one-score game. Second down, goal to go. On the ground, McCaffrey. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the 49ers have a chance to tie things up as they trail by two here in the fourth. All right, now what can the Niners do as they face a big two-point conversion here? They're going to try and run for it. He's not going to get there. The defense able to come up with a big stop, and they're going to hold on to their two-point lead. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And this will be our first chance in the new season to see the new fair catch rule for 2023. And this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing. On the give, it's Warren. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout. Now they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. That one looks like he'll throw here. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Credit the sack to Fred Warner. Second and 14. They'll try the right side with Harris. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw it, quick throw out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that.
Try to take this home, they'll run. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. The Steelers send out their punter now as he's on for the fifth time here today. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Wow, a personal foul at this stage in the fourth. Hard to believe.
Really hard to believe. And now that glow of hope that you had begins to flicker out, doesn't it?
Yep. Pick it down to a knee, and that is going to do it. And just how they envisioned the start of the season, kneeling it down, defense can't stop the clock. This one's a winner.
You know, it's really strange. I think a lot of people think that the kneel down practice stuff really only happens like one time a week. The best teams I know, they practice starting back in OTAs. They want them to visualize winning a game and how great that feels, and they got it done in this one.
Yep, a knee gets them to 1-0. They go down to a knee, and the new campaign off to a good start. It's a win here in week one. The city always a little extra excitement for week one, and one of our early window games here in week one on a Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
And it's good to be back in the booth with you as well. And we know that not everyone's going to start the season 1-0, right? Half the league is going to have a loss on their record. But everyone's got to build off of that opener. And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week one and week two.